We have new information about a triple homicide in St. Paul over the weekend. Police have identified the victims and say they do know who pulled the trigger. Lou Ragus joins us now with the latest on the investigation. Lou?
Well, Julie, they haven't made any arrests yet, but they say they know who they're looking for as they attempt to solve what resulted in what they call one of the most complex murder scenes that they've ever investigated.
I know I speak on behalf of all of us when I say we're tired of these press conferences. We're tired of these midnight calls. We're tired of these incidents playing out in our community over and over and over and over and over again.
Across the street from the scene of a grisly murder, Mayor Melvin Carter, along with police and community leaders, voiced frustration.
What happened last night is just plain unacceptable.
This is a photo of 42-year-old Corey Freeman, shared with Care 11 by a friend of his. He, along with 33-year-old Angelica Gonzalez and 44-year-old Maisha Spaulding, are identified by St. Paul police as the victims who were shot to death in this house on Case Avenue in the Payne Phelan neighborhood. Two other people were wounded and hospitalized. The killer has not been found, but police believe they know who it was.
We believe we do, yes.
Interim Chief Jeremy Ellison says they've been called to this house many times before.
We are doing a deep dive into the calls for service at that address, and we're going to, you know, take a hard look at whether we missed anything or could have done something differently. But at this time, it appears that we've done everything we could have done, given the information we had at the time.
The owner of the rental property tells Care 11 just Friday he evicted the tenants. It's unclear who among the victims was living there. Community leaders urge those who know something to come forward, help facilitate the shooter turning himself in, and not to resort to retaliation.
The way to honor the legacy of those who are deceased is not more violence. We want to eradicate violence from the community.
Again, a lot of the details we have about this shooting are vague. We don't know a motive or what led up to the incident, and we don't know if police are looking for just one person or actually multiple people. Julie.
All right. Thank you, Lou. We will continue to follow this story both on air and online at care11.com. You can also follow the latest by downloading the Care 11 app.